Very good morning, my dear student. So today I am going to discuss about the Python Panda condition loop, iterations and implementations of the while condition. So how we can use that particular while conditions in a different way. In the previous videos you have seen it, that how we have used the while condition and how we have implemented the while conditions, and within while condition how we have used the other particular loop also. So this is the thing what we can find it, that we are using this particular structure, we are making this particular pattern of the program where we are giving some condition. Okay, so this is the conditional loop that we are making, that means it is also doing the work of iterations, doing the thing again and again, and along with the while conditional system. Okay, so we find it that this particular while conditional system will going to work, and how it is working, let us see. Now using the while loop, see this particular program. In this particular program what we can find it, that we are doing here the sum of the first 10 natural number with while and else. Okay, so here what has been done, at first I have taken one variable. In this variable, the variable is s. So this particular variable what I have declared it, that s equals to 0. Okay, and x equals to 1. So this is the initialization has been done here. After the initialization has been done here, in this particular initialization, now you see the particular condition has been given. What is the condition has been given? That x is less than 11. Okay, x is less than 11. So this particular thing has been done. So when this particular thing has been done, we can find it, that we are working and we are making the particular structures, and we are having this particular pattern. Fine. So these are the things, or these are the part that we can see, or that we can find it, that when we are working there, what we have given, some particular structural form. So as we have given some structural form, in this structural form that we find it, that each of this particular structural form that we are working with and we are making it, we are going to have this particular structures, and we are going to join this particular pattern. So pattern is what? That pattern is a checking that whether the value of x is less than 11 or not. So equal to is not given, it is less than 11 or not. That means it will start from the 0 and it will going to run up to 11. So how we will going to do it? So see here, that it has written s equals to s plus x, so accumulating the sum. Okay, x, that we are taking the value of x, that means s value is what, 0, the 0 plus 1 means first one. Now what has been done, the value of x has been increased. So it has the incrementer has been used here. What is the incrementer? X equals to x plus 1. This is the incrementer. So as this particular incrementer is there, in this particular incrementer, what we find it, that we will going to have this particular incrementer, and we will going to design this particular incrementer. That means why we are designing this incrementer, because we required it to increase, and we make the particular thing to be workable. Now what it has written, else, then print the sum of first 10 natural number. What is the sum of first 10 natural number is there? This the thing will going to be accumulated, and it will going to do. Now where it is doing, where it is calculating? It is calculating here, because when it see that x equals to x plus 1, then it will going to enter here, and after entering in this particular area, what we can find it here, that we will going to have the particular structures, and we are making this particular structure. Okay, that means one by one it will increase, and as the x value is increasing, the x value is increasing, the s also going to increase, and this particular So you can see here that what we have done it here in this particular area, we are constructing, we are making the particular structure, and based on this particular structure we have this particular form, we have this particular phenomenon based on which what we have done, the thing is been implemented. The highlighted point, what we can find it, that the highlighted point is been implemented here. Okay, so as we find this particular point is been implemented here, this is what we can see here, that we will going to increase. Okay, we will going to increase this thing, but this increment, this particular pattern of increment that we are having, that we are incrementing it. As we are incrementing it, what we find it, that this is the structure what we have, or this is the pattern what we have. In this particular pattern, we are finding what? The sum of our 10 natural number using the while and else. Okay, so now let us see that what is there. Let us find out what is the output that we are going to get. So now you can see here in this particular phase, in this particular pattern, we have a output. Output what? Sum of a 10 natural number. So if you add it, and if you find it that this particular structure, if you see it, this particular structure, we can find it that there are the different type of data that we are using it here. Okay, and we are making the particular structure here. So the structures that we are making it here, the structures that we are allocating it here in this particular pattern, in this particular area, what do we find it? That we have the natural number, that means the 10 natural number, those the 10 natural number we are adding it, and we need to find out the output. So how, what the output? Output is 55, isn't it? So this is how, that means how it is been done. We find it, it is been incrementing. Okay, the thing has been incrementing what? One by one, and as the S has been incrementing, based on this particular incrementation, we find it, the thing is been accumulated, and thing has been done. So this is what the output that we get, and based on this output, we have our particular program. That means the logic that has been given, that is a true, isn't it? Now let us see the next program, what is there. Now see the next program. In this particular program, what you can see and what you can find it here, that program to find the product of the first natural number. Okay, first natural number, the number is from 1 to 10, that means product means what? Multiplication, isn't it? That means 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 up to 10. So you have to take the input from the user. So as you are taking the input from the user, what the user will going to give the input. So to taking the input from the user, what it has been given? N equals to int input enter n. Okay, so n equals to int input enter n, and so this is the particular thing, this is the particular pattern that we find it, that we are having it. That means what? We are taking the integer, we are taking the input from the particular user. So when we are taking the input from the particular user, okay, as we are taking the input from the particular user, what we find it here, that this the input what is there, this the part of input what is there, that is been initialized and that has been implemented, that p equals to 1 and I equals to 1. Okay, so p equals to 1 and I equals to 1, after that p equals to 1 and I equals to 1 means what? That we have initialized the two values. So as we have initialized the two value, now you see what has been done. One loop has been framed here. Okay, what is the loop? Loop is a while loop. So while what has been done? I value is less than equals to n. So when I value is less than equals to n, there we find that p equals to p into I, and I equals to I plus 1. So these are the two things that we find, these are the two pattern that we find, that we are having this particular pattern of the structures, and we are having this particular pattern that we are working with. Okay, so as we are working with, in this particular thing what we have given, we have find out that print the product. So we need to print out the product. So as we need to print out the product, in this particular product, product means what? P. So P means what? That we are calculating the value. What we are doing? P equals to P into I. So what is the value of I? Initialize, I have initialized the P value is 1 and I value also 1. So this way, after it is being done what? I is been incremented. Okay, it is an increment counter or update counter also. So as it is an increment counter or update counter, in this increment counter or update counter, what we find it that I equals to I plus 1. Okay, I equals to I plus 1. So as we find that I equals to I plus 1, this the particular pattern or this the particular type that we are implementing here, that we are implementing in this area, then we will going to have the output. Okay, we will going to have the output, and based on this particular output, what we find it that each and every output of it, each and every part of the output of it will going to be initialized in this particular logic that has been given. Okay, so this is the logic what we find, this is the logic what we see, that each and every part of the logic that is there, each and every part of the logic that we are implementing here, but as we are implementing the fact, as we are finding the part, that means in each of this part, how we are making the initializations. So first we have taken the value of L. Okay, so that the value of n what we have taken from the user. Why? Because we need one comparization whether the value is less than what? Less than I value is less than n or not. Okay, n is greater than I or not. If it is so, then it will going to do. So let us see how the output it will going to give to us. Now you see that how the thing is working. So it has asked to enter the value of n. Suppose I have entered the value of n is 5. Okay, so when you give enter, see product is 120. That means 5 I have given. So up to 5 time it has done the multiplication, and doing the multiplication up to 5 time, it has find out this particular output. Okay, so whatever the value that you will going to give, whatever the value that you will going to find it here, based on this particular value and based on this particular part, that you are going to emphasize on it, and you will going to make this particular product, you will make this particular production, and in this particular production you will going to have this particular output. Okay, so this is how we can do the work. This is how we can find that how this particular thing will going to work. Now let us see what is the next program we do have with us, and how it will going to implement. Now see the next program. Next program is what? Here also we have implemented a while loop. So as we have implemented it here, while loop, see here a very short program that has been given it here. So in this particular small program or short program, what we have done, that count equals to 0. Okay, so count value equals to 0. As we have made the count value is 0, that means we have initialized the first value. As we have initialized the first value, in this area what we find, that while count less than 11, that means we will going to do that part, that means it will going to print how many time? 11 time the thing will going to print. That means 0 to 10 means 11 time it will going to print. Okay, so as we are going to print for the 11th time, then what we find it here, that we have a print. So this way also you can write it, print the count is what? Count. Okay, so that it will going to print. So this, when it will going to print this particular thing, then you see here one incrementer has been given here. What is the incrementer? That count equals to count plus 1. That means what will be the value of count? That will be incremented by 1. So this way what we can find, the loop will going to proceed, or loop will going to run. So when we find it that the loop will going to proceed or loop will going to run, this particular thing, this particular structure that we have, this particular part that we have, we are implementing it here. We are making the particular structure here. In this particular structure, we are doing or we are working in this particular area. Okay, so as we are doing or as we are making in this particular area that we are working with, this particular area that we are implementing it, what we have done, what we have implemented or what we have used. So we find here the particular thing that we are implementing, the particular part that we are making it. Okay, so when we are making this particular structures, when we are implementing this particular structures, that in each of these particular structures or in each of the part, we are having the construction, those the constructions is been done and those the constructions is been given in a way or in a form that when we find that we do have a pattern of a values. Isn't it? We do have a pattern of a value. So what is the pattern of a value is there? The particular pattern of value that we do have, the particular pattern of value that we construct. What the construction that we make? That we make a construction here to make the structures to be work in a loop. That means again iterations. So when it do the iterations, it will go to iterate it again and again. The loop will iterate again and again. As we find it, this particular loop will be iterating again and again. We find that this particular structure of the loop, what happened? It will come inside and it will check whether the value is less than 11 or not. Isn't it? First time it will go, it will come, again it will go, it will come, again it will go, it will come. So this way 11 times, that means all total it will do it for 12 times. That means when count will be 11, that means it is became a 12 time. When count will be 11, what it will do? That particular loop what is there, the particular loop what we can find, that it will check whether 11 is less than 11. No. So as it is not, then it will quit out from the loop and then it will going to print the particular value. Okay, so this is the particular thing, this is the particular part that we find, this is the particular structure that we find, that where we are working it and where we are making the particular pattern. This particular pattern is what is our constructional phase, is our constructional structure. Okay, so in this particular constructional structure, in this particular constructional matter, we do have this particular frame, or we do design this particular frame. Okay, so when we are designing this frame, when we are making this particular frame that we are designing, this particular frame that we are working with, we are making the particular structure in such a way, in such a phenomenon, that each of this particular phenomena will going to be concentrate and going to be make a value, the value that what we are using on it. Okay, so we are using this particular structures, we are making this particular structures. So as we are making this particular structures, for what purpose? We are making the particular structures for the purpose of what? For the purpose of running the particular frame, for doing the particular structures in such a way, in such a form, that we find it, that we will going to have this particular phenomenon and we will going to work on this particular phenomenon. Okay, so this is the phenomenon that we are constructing, this is the phenomenon that we are making it. What we are doing originally, we are iterating the loop, we are making the loop again and again, we are finding that the loop will going to run again and again. As we find the loop will going to run again and again, that many number of time the work will be constructed. So when it come out from the loop, when we find the thing is come outing from the loop, then there will be some conclusion. So let's see what is the output of it. So see this particular pattern, see this particular structure. What it has been done, that means here you can see in this particular way also we can do the counting, we can do the printing. Okay, so count is first value of the count is what, 0, then the count value is 1, then the count value is 2, isn't it? So there we can see it that in each of the particular area, in each of the particular part, it has done for how many times? For the 10 times the thing has been done. As we find that 10 times the thing has been done, after the thing has been done for 10 times, and when it check, yes, it is 11. It is 11. 11 is less than 11. No, then it will going to quit out and it will write what? A goodbye. Isn't it? So this is the thing, this is the part of the implementation that we can do, and we can work on it. Okay. So this is what for today's. I am ending my today's session here. Thank you all.